So crow pose. Crow pose seems to be up there on the top of the list of poses that you would like me to talk you through. So I've chosen crow for today. I tend to teach crow a couple of different ways, and it completely depends on who I'm teaching. If you're fairly new to crow, never tried crow before, I'm going to go over that variation first, and then a second, and then I've even got a cheeky little third variation for anybody who is a little bit scared of perhaps face planting, which is a totally legitimate fear to have, by the way, because it hurts if you crash down on your nose. So feel free to grab all the cushions, blankets, anything that you need that is just going to take that fear factor away from you, because that sometimes really is half of the battle. So let's get cracking. So obviously I would have liked you to warm up the wrists a little bit, maybe even a bit of hip opening so that we can get into the posture. So let's just assume that we've warmed up and we're just going to come into the posture. So we're going to start by coming down into a little bit of a squat. So the first variation, this one, is what I tend to teach people who have never lifted into crow before. And so this variation, we'll bring the knees to the side of the arms rather than to the back of the triceps. And it doesn't matter which variation you start with, just have fun with your practice, be playful with it, because it is supposed to be fun. It's not supposed to be draining all of the time. So hands are going to come shoulder distance apart. Really spread the fingers, because your fingertips, your knuckles are going to become your feet and your toes to help you balance. So with the hands shoulder distance apart, I'm going to lift the hips so we can bring the knees either side of the arms, top of the arms. And then we're going to look forward. If we look down, we don't want to go that way, so we're going to look ahead. And then all we're going to do, as we look ahead, bringing the knees to the outside of the arms, as we start to bend into the elbows and lean forward, or it gets a bit scary, you'll feel your tummy want to fire up. Let it. Draw your navel in towards your spine. Activate your Uddiyana Bandha. And then the first thing we do would be to squeeze your knees into the arms. And that squeezing action is going to allow you to then lift the feet off of the mat. You might do one toe tap, maybe tap the toes till we build that confidence. And then when you're ready, just come out. If you do roll forward, just go with it, literally go with the flow. Rather than going all rigid and tense, your best just to tuck the chin in and hope for the best. So that's one variation. The second variation is where we bring the knees up a lot higher into the underarm area. It is a little bit harder to maintain, I think, because it's more drawing upwards energy rather than that hugging in towards the side of the body that we've just done. So you will need to activate your Uddiyana Bandha, which is your navel lock, navel pulls in towards your spine, and your Mula Bandha, which is essentially your pelvic floor muscle. So as you start to lift in, engage those bandhas, and you'll find it'll be a lot easier to maintain, and maybe get more of a lift. The other thing is breathe. Please breathe. There's a little trick that I do. If I know I tend to hold my breath on a posture, I'll lift into the asana, whether it's a headstand, handstand, whatever it is, as I exhale. That way, I've got no choice but to take another breath in. Whereas if I inhale, go into crow, it's very likely that we'll hold that breath and then we'll wonder why we're not staying in flight. So the second one, again, hand shoulder distance apart. We're going to tuck the knees now a little bit closer. Get them as close to the underarm as you can. It's going to make life a lot easier for you. Then we're going to tuck the knees in. Bend the elbows, suppressing into the fingertips, into the knuckles. Looking forward, starting activating those bandhas, and then seeing if perhaps we can float one leg and then the other. Breathe. And you can obviously hold for as long as you like. And then when you're ready, release the feet. And you can drop the hips, maybe into Malasana. Obviously you can jump back, go into headstand. Lots of funky things you can do, but let's master the crow before we go for those. And if you're sitting there thinking, no and no, I've got you covered as well. So if you want to experience the sensations of crow without the fear of face planting, this variation is a reclined variation. It really activates those core muscles. And if you're holding it right, you will feel the effects of it, and you'll get some kind of idea of what it feels like when you turn yourself over and you take your flying crow. So with this one, come down onto your back, and we're going to take the knees wide,
big toes together. Then with the hands, we're going to face the palms facing skywards, and you're going to press the sky away or the ceiling as if it's coming down on you. So as you inhale, we're going to lift the chest, bring the elbows into the knees into the elbows, and at the same time as pushing the whole time, you are pushing the knees into your elbows into your knees. And you'll feel that Uddiyana Bandha, that Mula Bandha, and all those tummy muscles engage. You can see I'm shaking. If you're shaking, you know you're holding it in the right spot. And you can obviously release when you're ready and come out when you're ready. But that's a really nice way to practice crow, to get the sensations that we experience in it sometimes, or even just to build a bit of confidence. And actually, you don't always have to take crow one way. Obviously, I'm sure most of you know this, side crow or the other different crows. But why not take a little recline crow from time to time? What's stopping you? If I have missed anything, there is other ways that you can obviously come in and out of crow, but they are the two main ways that I tend to teach it. Hopefully that's given you some useful information and you can go ahead and fly or not fly, because it's equally fine if you don't. Remember, yoga isn't always about these funky postures. It's about showing up for ourselves. Although the funky postures are a little bit fun. So yeah, if you do try it and you manage to take flight, and even if you don't, let me know how you get on, because I'd love to see your beautiful crows. Have a lovely day, and I'll see you soon. Let me know what other tutorials or which other postures you would perhaps like me to break down. That'd be great, because I'd rather do postures that you want to learn about rather than the ones that I just like doing. So yeah, have a lovely day, and I'll see you soon.